Hello guys, welcome to another video. First of all, I want to say sorry. Because despite of what I said in my previous video that I was going to be more constant with the channel, things just get in the way. First, when I was actually going to get up and make a video, I got terribly sick. I actually think I got the coronavirus, but I'm okay now. I'm pretty good, I just have a kind of a sore throat. So yeah, I want to say sorry because I actually tried to make this video way earlier, like 3 weeks ago, but I just couldn't do it. And I want to welcome the 2022-ish subscribers that have subscribed to my channel since my last video, so welcome. But yeah, let's stop with the bullshit, because you came here to see the guitar that's in the title of this video. Because today we will be reviewing the Dean Cadillac X. The general consensus of Dean is kind of mixed. A lot of people like the guitars and a lot of people hate them, mainly because they are not conventionally shaped, although they are. Because basically what Dean does with their more famous models is combine two Gibson shapes together, like the famous ML shape that Dan McDarrell helped popularize. Like the guitar I have with myself today, which you can see is basically the bottom half of a Les Paul and the top half of an Explorer, which sounds kind of weird at the beginning, but I like it very much because it gives you that nice rounded feel of a Les Paul when you have it in your leg, but you have that pretty good fret axis that Explorers have. Also, one of the things that people most dislike about Dean is the headstock. Yeah, this is a headstock only a modder could love. So let me give you the specs of this guitar. This is one of Dean's not entry-level models, but low-end models. So this guitar features a basswood top and body. It has a nice bolt-on maple neck, which has a 22-fret rosewood fretboard, which is 24¾-inch scaling, like a Gibson. And they have a rounded C-neck profile. And for the configuration, you have your regular Les Paul configuration. This has two ceramic humbuckers, one three-way toggle switch, one volume and tone control for each pickup, and a tunomatic bridge. The pickups that come in this guitar are the DMT designed Zebra ceramic humbuckers. And despite being ceramic, they have pretty good bass and response to them. One of the things I actually kinda dislike about this guitar is the fact that the strap button is one of the bolts in the back of the neck plate. Why is this a bad thing? At least for me, I have a pretty big hand, and when I'm playing in these upper frets, I tend to wrap my hand around the neck. So when I come to these last frets, I wrap my hand around this and this thing just pushes into my hand. But if you play normally, like from the bottom of the neck, it's perfectly fine, you won't notice it at all. I was forgetting, but this guitar also has Grover-like tuners. They are pretty much Grover replicas, but they are not Grover branded. But they are pretty good. Also, these models are currently made in China. One of the things I hear most as a criticism of these entry-level Dean X guitars, you know, the Cadillac X, the MLX and the ZX, is that they have horrible fretwork. And as all my other guitars I reviewed, this is an used model, but I asked the previous owner and he said to me that he didn't make any kind of fretwork to this guitar. He didn't have any luthier or guitar tech to make any kind of fretwork. These are the fret ends as they came out of the factory, and to be honest with you, they are pretty good. When you run your hand through the neck, you can't feel any single fret. They are also pretty rounded in the ends. So I have heard a lot of criticism about sharp fret ends, but I don't see that at all in this guitar. As you can see, I can run my hand through the neck, and honestly, I'm being 100% honest, I can't feel anything. So on that end, it is pretty good. It came with kind of high action. The guy also said he never touched that, but I corrected that, you just have to lower the bridge a little bit. So yeah, these guitars get a lot of bad reputation within, you know, players, because a lot of people say they have bad fretwork, the hardware is pretty bad, and the pickups sound horrible, and they are ugly and whatnot. But I honestly don't think so. I have played a lot worse on also branded guitars. Like, if you ask me, Ibanez has a horrible low end of guitars. And if you like the Cadillac shape for some reason, this is a pretty good guitar to get into DIN guitars, in my opinion. And this guitar, despite being kinda cheap, it has a pretty good weight. It actually feels a lot like a Les Paul when you're playing it, despite the neck being a C profile. And the finish is also a very thick gloss finish, but it doesn't feel like cheap or toyish at all, like a lot of low-end Ibanez and Epiphone guitar feels. So yeah, that's basically all the specs about this guitar, so let's jump right into the demo. For today, I will be using my Randall RG75W combo amp and my Moore GE100 for some of the effects you may or may not hear. So let's go right into the demo! We'll be right back. So as you guys heard, this guitar doesn't sound bad at all. The pickups are kind of trebly, but they are not horrible like, let's say, Ibanez pickups. And the neck pickup is actually surprisingly thick for a ceramic humbucker. So as I said, this guitar feels pretty nice to play. It doesn't have any problems with the frets at all. I had maybe two other Dean guitars that also came with pretty nice fretwork, so maybe I just got the good examples, but my experience with Dean is they have pretty good fretwork from the factory. And I get it, Deans are kinda ugly, I'll admit that, but they are kind of an acquired taste. Because it also happened to me that the first time I saw a Cadillac or an ML, I went like, what the actual fuck is that? Are Dean designers like fucking drunk? Who is going to buy all of these guitars, maybe apart from Pantera fans or whatever? But when you actually get them and start playing them, they are pretty good guitars in my opinion. Of course they are not the best guitars ever, but for the price I think they are not bad at all. It doesn't go out of tune pretty regularly, I guess the normal amount for a guitar of this price. The pickups have actually a pretty nice tone to it, and it feels like a pretty solid guitar, so yeah, I like it, I give it a pass. So yeah, that is basically all that I have to say about this guitar. If you like this video, please leave a like down below. Again, I am really, really, really sorry for the inconsistency I have displayed in these past months on this channel. I am actually making an effort to pull out more videos, but life keeps getting in the way. But I invite you to take a look at my channel and my other videos, and if you like them, please subscribe to my channel. I will actually try to make more videos this following months. And if you know someone that may be looking for one of these guitars, or may want a Dean guitar, but they don't know if they're good or bad, please send them this video or just share it wherever you want. I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye! So yeah, as you guys heard this